Getting old's awesome. I got butt surgery done last year. Anyone else? Minor. Just thought I had a little, found a little lump on the inside of one of my butt cheeks and figured, that's a hemorrhoid, I guess. I'm due at my age. I'm past 40. Went to one of those specialists. Problem is, I got one of those fresh off the Civil War battlefield doctors. Ever get those guys? No bedside manner whatsoever. It's like, no, that's no hemorrhoid. That's an inflamed cyst. We got to cut that wide open. Why wide open? What doctor says wide open? An Old West doctor? I started laughing. He goes like, no way around it. Put on the gown. And he left. And I did it. I put the gown on, laid in the gurney like a good boy, because I'm trying to live. When I was younger and unafraid, I'd be like, no, I don't trust you. I don't, I'm not taking my clothes off. I'm 22. I'm fine. Get out of there. Now, at 42, I will walk into the lobby of a hospital I've never been in. Dick out. Like, does this rash look weird? No, do you work here? Miss, I don't care. I just want to live, right? So I lay it on the gurney, and he comes back in, wheeling in his tools from the movie Seven, and he goes, I need an assistant on this. Do you mind? I'm like, bring the gang, right? And he's like, all right, I appreciate that. It's a young intern. Chris! Chris? Say doctor for me. Don't just call your boy, okay? Chris comes in, and Chris, it sounds like a seven-year-old kid. Like, he's gonna come in, drop his baseball mitt. What seemed to be the problem? Like, get out of here, Chris. And Chris is not seven, but he's like 24, and he's, to this day, my favorite doctor, because he's made me laugh more than any doctor, because he comes in, putting on rubber gloves, says nothing to me, sits, I'm like this, sits down behind me, grabs my butt cheeks, and just opens them. No hello. Like, buy me a drink, Chris. Give me a kiss in the neck, straight to anal. You men, you young men move so fast, right? So I'm kind of giggling and hiding it. And the doctor injects me the anesthetic that does nothing. And while Chris is holding it open, you know, starts cutting. Hurts like a bitch. In fact, I'm punching the wall, yelling motherfucker again and again. And the doctor says, and I quote, yeah, that's good, curse. It raises your pain threshold. No, it doesn't. Not at all. But then Chris, who's holding my butt open, remember Chris? He says something that makes me laugh so hard I have to turn my head away. Because that's weird. If they're operating on my butt and I'm like, like, no, that makes everything. He's enjoying this too much. Chris doesn't know I can hear him, but I overhear him. I guess he's exerting himself. I hear him go, hey, doctor, yeah, you might want to hurry up because my shoulders are getting kind of tired. Are you fucking kidding me, man? There's a knife in between those cheeks, Chris. I'm going to be anally scarred because you can't do a pull-up, for real. And the reason why that's awesome to me is because that is the sound of the young male ego cracking, okay? I'll give you a primer on the male ego. When you're Chris's age, when you're young, your male ego's enormous but fragile, like a big egg made of sugar, right? You make a lot of boasts and brags you can't back up. When you're my age, male ego is small but tough, like an old-timey football, right? I don't care if you think I'm weak. I'm not going to brag about something I can't do. Like if I was helping one of you fine folks move into a new house, which is not going to happen. Don't ever ask. But if I was, I'm carrying my end of an armoire or something, and my arms are hurting, I'm telling the world. I'm not going to power through and hurt myself. I'd be like, hey, I'm going to drop this thing. My arms hurt. Help! You think I'm weak? I don't care. But if I was Chris's age, helping, say, a girl move, I would have let both my shoulders dislocate before I showed a moment's weakness. And the moment I was about to die on my feet, I would have asked for help, but in the most cool, casual manner I could muster, just bones bending in my limbs, covered in flop sweat, like, hey, April? Yeah, it's me, wronger. Listen, if someone's to help me, it's probably not the worst idea. I'm bleeding from the eyes, ears, nose, and anus right now. April, help! And Chris did that with my ass. I had no idea my butt cheeks had the tensile strength of a bear trap, till that day. Poor Chris was holding up an alligator's mouth the whole time, like, no! Help! No! Finally, the doctor is just like, we're clear, whoop-pow! Like a sonic boom throughout the parking lot.